Remember when the media was freaking out over the hypothetical scenario where Trump would claim voter fraud if he lost the election? But then he won the election and it ended up being the media and the Democrats that claimed election fraud. Yeah, I remember too, but the DNC operatives at MSNBC have apparently forgotten, or more likely, they chose to forget.
It's really important. This is, I think, one of the most important things. In his close, and I've said that people that know Trump will understand this, when he said Trump will not leave office in a transit, yes, in a normal, peaceful. I've said, Trump, you have to understand something.
Yes, you have to understand that the left-wing media goes hyperbolic anytime there's a Republican president. When Bush was president, the media often referred to it as the Bush regime to give the impression that he was illegitimately occupying the White House. Near the end of his presidency, people in the media began fear-mongering that when Bush's terms would up, he wouldn't leave office and would become a dictator. And in fact, all of the same things that the media says about Trump today, that he's a racist, that he's an idiot, they said all the same things about Bush when he was president. So Donnie Douche, you're going to have to forgive me if I completely dismiss your ridiculous lamentations.
He did it in the last election. When he thought he was going to lose, he was teeing it up for a few days. I mean, it's easy to forget that now.
No, it's not really easy to forget because people on my side have been pointing out for years that it ended up being you in the media that challenged the election results. Hey, what do you call this entire Russian collusion hoax? It started from the very beginning and has to this day had not a single shred of evidence to back it up. The only purpose of it was to delegitimize Trump in the election. Ever since the day Trump was elected, you and the media have not relented in your temper tantrum, even if it means tearing this country apart. This is yet another case of people in the media lacking any sense of self-awareness because they live in this democratic bubble of propaganda.
Even if he loses an election, whatever in a movie you think this guy is capable of doing to create a civil war, he will do. I know that's, I'm not speaking in hyperbole.
A civil war? If there was a civil war, the blame would be placed squarely on the fake news media that chose to be political propaganda instead of doing their job as the fourth estate and holding all government accountable, not just Republican governments. This isn't the first time that Donnie Douchebag has promoted the idea of civil unrest or civil war. Just last year, he was telling Democrats to go out in the streets and start a violent revolution simply because he didn't like the way the election ended.
Our democracy is under siege. People need to start taking to the streets. This is a dictator. This is not something to analyze anymore.
Yeah.
And if you're a 12-year-old and the future is in front of you, this is terrifying. This is not time to analyze and pundit. People, this is a, we need a revolution at this point.
Again, isn't it the media and the Democrats who have been claiming that the election was stolen since day one? These people have a serious problem with projecting their flaws and their strategies onto their opposition. It's plainly obvious that their strategy from the very beginning has been to undo this election by any means necessary. So how can these people sit around and hypothesize about what Trump might do when they have already done it? And the truth is, it's them that won a civil war. I've talked before about how the left and the media want to criminalize their political opposition. And this is just another example of that. They want a civil war because it would give them a chance to get rid of their political opposition once and for all. Trump is not going to stay past his term. Why would he want to do that? You think he likes being a constant target 24/7? I mean, he isn't even getting paid for this job. He donates all of his paychecks to charity, which, of course, the media pays no attention to. My guess is that when his time is up, he will gladly leave office. There's literally no reason to think otherwise.